Hey guys, Vivi-chan here and welcome back to my channel. Today we are finally continuing with Attack on Titan. I know, it's been 3 weeks. I know I hate myself too. I don't know why I keep doing this. I have got to like catch up. It's almost time for spring anime and I'm just so behind. But I got 3 episodes of ALT. I don't know why last week they skipped it. I think because of daylight savings or holiday? I could be wrong. I don't even know. Let's just get into episodes 72, 73, and 74. Oh my gosh, I'm so excited. Like, Eren's got his thing. I hope nothing happens to Sasha's family. Like, oh my gosh, it could go left. Oh my god, everything is so messed up. Let's see what's gonna happen. And play. Wow, everything's so pretty, so peaceful. A bad omen. I don't know why I can see Eren just... Oh, steam? Oh my god, wait, is there Reiner in there? Oh no, the plan? Who? This Zeke? Is this from the past? Oh, this is what happened at Connie's. Oh. Yeah, Levi's gonna make you remember everything. Yeah, he needs to ingrain that in your head. I mean, you say you just did it to side with, but... Oh, Levi's the most popular person, character. About Eren? Oh. La 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 di da 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 di 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 da di di da. Da di 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 da. Yeah, I brought the pink mirror back. yeah, anyways, back to this episode. Or, I mean, not this episode. The previous episode. Whoa, I can't believe it's been 3 weeks. Yeah, I didn't even rewatch. I just kind of skimmed through the previous episode. I know Zachary has passed. Dang. For him to go just like that. And then Pixies has to do the thing. Well, that sounded scarier than usual. Oh yeah, her name's Mia. Look, there's four kids, just like the last time. Two of them are gonna die. Does the Marlin captive really work here? Oh, he purposely showed them. Oh. Yeah, if you're gonna give me free food, bring the whole family. Oh, but we all got that bad gut feeling. I don't know, girl. I don't know. This is not a good idea. Gabby, you don't deserve this food. Whoa, that's a huge claim. Does he know? I wonder if he's ever had such nice food. Yeah, imagine that. Sasha loving someone more than food. I'm just remembering season two, where that guy never got to drink that last drop. What? Is there a bomb in there? Is there something sneaky going on? No. Well, that took a turn. I don't know if he was hiding something or he meant it. I think he's hiding something. I really don't think she should be helping. Oh my gosh, she's gonna see something. Oh, he heard about the restroom. I don't know if you should reveal your warrior candidates. Oh But this is what people want, right?
Why'd you take the hit for her?
If he's dead, I won't even believe it. Oh my God. I don't know what to think. Like, oh my God. Oh. Shut your mouth, girl. I think he's gonna do the right thing. I would be shocked if he hurt her. I think he's gonna forgive. Is there poison in the wine? Did he did? I can't even think. Some of the soldiers were drinking it last time. And how did it get there? Because Yelena in the Jaeger is actually controlling it. Damn, those flashbacks in the background. Damn. Oh my God. Oh my God, I'm so shy to see him there. Oh! drop the guns. Calm down. I guess they have to be wary, but still. We reject your proposal. They know where. Am I flippin' hate this guy? Oh my god, I'm like the most uncomfortable feeling inside. Man, that threat, just look at that blood pouring on the table. Alright, let's talk. Anything at the end? Okay, I'm just moving on to the next episode. Okay, next episode. Man, this is getting so wild. The wine being spiked with Zeke's spinal fluid. And I flip and hate Flop's like devious smile. Ugh, I hate it. And of course, everyone here knows that Gabby's the one who killed Sasha. It takes a lot, but the father decides to forgive her to end the cycle. And like, she's just so shocked that, you know, Amarle is siding with the Eldians. And she's shocked that the Eldian is forgiving her. Like, yeah, that doesn't match up. And now she's face to face with Eren. And, I don't know if he's gonna try to convince Mikasa and Armin to come. Ah! This is, I don't know, it's like so, I'm so conflicted right now. Ay. Alright, play. Oh, we're going back a little bit. Yeah, see, even like all the Eldians here know, everyone knows she kills Sasha, but they're willing to forgive her. She's just a kid. That's essentially what the father said, right? You gotta get out of the forest. And poor Falco, he keeps taking an L to protect her. I'm tired of hearing kill, kill, kill. And he just casually walks in. And just automatically, like, to threaten them. I got that blood on. Oh man, and Mikuro, man. At first, when he was like, don't drink that, you guys are like filthy Eldians, whatnot. Like, I knew he was hiding something. And oh wow, he actually had like a huge crush. Like, I think crush is not the right word, but like, he feels thankful that Sasha was there to make him love Eldians. And I do think he felt some confusion about him liking Eldians. I mean, that's why he saved like Connie and John from drinking it, or else they'd have the spinal fluid. And then, like you saw from the beginning of the previous episode, as long as you inhale, like the gas had Zeke's spinal fluid, right? As long as you intake some of Zeke's spinal fluid, he can just, you know, scream or whatever, do his thing and like ignite that power to transform them. Dang, and then Kaya is what's her name? Kaya? Man, like out of everyone, she was the one that felt the most betrayed. And yeah, sure thing, because she was the one who respected Sasha the most. But it's just my heart goes out to them when they're all crying over there about Sasha. I feel bad the most for Falco. Yeah. And then man, I kind of feel bad for Hanji because I don't know if because they think the Pixis and them is betraying, but I don't think he is. And then poor Levi, he's like, all this work over the years and this happens. Look at that coldness in his eyes. Uh-oh. He's gonna ruin it. Gosh, just has her hands on the table. I mean, off the table. I mean, Casa's like your sister. Oh, you think Bertolt's got some influence? Oh shiz. Man, keep revealing truth after truth. Is this the truth? Like, there's like some kind of truth to it. Oh, shiz. Yeah, punch that guy. But I don't think that do nothing. You were too scared. Damn, this. I'm lost for words. You were the one that started it, Eden. We weren't even thinking about slave till you started it. Man, this soundtrack when it was like, yeah, dun 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 dun, man, that brought back season one vibes. I wonder, Aquamans can't turn into Titans, right? Let me get the beast of someone else. But some of those people there were drinking some wine, right? So he could just. Oh no. He get up. Oh shiz, it's He's running from the Titans. Oh my God. Oh no! Oh fuck! He said there was like 30 people here. Fudge, and they're falling in the sky. Oh my goodness gracious. Turn into pure titans. Oh my God, they drink it. Even them? Oh my God. Did Pixis drink any? Oh my God. All the way here, they heard it too? Oh, this is so messed up. And he was just. Man. I never mentioned, but Levi's the only one who kept, like, the swords. Oh, and he sees them. Man, poor Levi. How many people is he gonna see turn into time? Oh, that time, that baseball glove, and yeah. No. He went out on all those. This is it. This is it. This. Cut him! I don't even care! Oh, man, he transformed. On your back, on your nape. You watch for that. Actually, don't. I want you to get sliced, Zeke. I totally want. Ew. Man, his red eyes. Yeah, he's been waiting to cut you. You thought it was gonna be so smooth. I just hope the Jaegerist don't come anytime soon. Come on, cut off those limbs. Well, that piece of flesh still moved. Oh my God, Keith. They look so unmotivated. Do they know what's up? Are they spies? And why'd you join if you don't care? You don't want to join MP? Oh, his parents made him. man, you gotta out the guy? But everyone is thinking that, huh? Damn. What the fudge, man? Leave him alone! Come on, you can have your thing, but do you have to beat him up? What the hell? You gonna put them in prison for not doing that? Look how chicken scared they are. Tell me Saudis beat them up. Oh, fudge. I can't believe this. They actually beat him up. I can't. I hate that smug face. I can't wait for him to. I know. Man, these actually, they're just sitting there waiting for them to bring Zeke? Damn. Yeah, it looks horrible. It's like, I should have done that from the beginning. Man, that blood moon sky. Oh, he looks like he's got like pox or something. Are those glasses, moment? Was it from his dad? It was his dad's glasses? Cassava? Oh! Is there anything at the end? Okay, we're just gonna skip the next episode. Well, let me check. Okay, there's nothing. Okay, 74 all caught up. Oh man, each episode I say this, but man, there's so many different types of feelings. Eden and his talk with Mikasa and Armin, I don't know if he's like pushing them away or if he, part of me doesn't really think he feels this way, just because, you know, even like a few episodes back, he still relied on them to come for him, and my heart was just torn apart seeing them fight. Whatever he said had like a twinge of truth, but the way he said it, it felt so like manipulative and like hurtful, and it just made his friends lose more faith. Oh my god, I was just like, I'm just speechless the whole time. And of course, Beast Titan thought turning all of Levi's comrades is going to hurt Levi's feelings. No, Levi's been through so much. How many times has he saw his comrades die in front of him? Yeah, and I knew we're in the forest, nothing for Beast Titan to throw except for like the other two Pure Titans' heads and bodies. Yeah, easy. And oh, I just hated that part at the end where they had to beat up Commander Sadis, Keith Sadis, Sadie Sadis. Man, that just hurt. He's from the old gen, and like you gotta beat down those old morals because everyone's with the Jaegers now, the cool people. Oh, I hate it when they beat him up. It felt so wrong. Yeah, and I flip and hate Flock. Like, out of everyone, I flip and hate Flock the most. Zeke right after, but like, I feel like we're gonna get into like his backstory and whatnot, so we'll have to see. Because he mentioned some like Kushla person. So, yeah, let's see who that is and play. Oh, is that his dad, Grisha? Oh, it's all the armbands. Well, that is a lot of pressure for the kid. Well, okay. I mean, I said at the beginning, like, flippin' hate Zeke, but at the same time, when he was young, I mean, he's got a purpose for doing this. It just, I feel like he's the reason everything is all wrong, but, like, you know, in the end, his plan with Eden is to, you know, help the Eldians. So, we'll have to see. But at the moment, it just... I'm just hurt that everything is not going right. I know this is not like a happy end story that I'm used to. This is like reality. This is the last war. Man. I hope we get to see like a flashback of what Eden and Zeke talked about. I mean, of course, Zeke told Eden, I think, about like a little bit of the Ackerman and Armin part. That's how he like knows. Or man, but yes, I'd love a backstory on Zeke and Grisha. And, yeah, about him growing up and yeah, because the person, Mr. Whoever he said, Claw, maybe he's like someone who looked after him. Maybe a senpai? Yeah. Maybe it was like the previous warrior candidate. Is it that guy? Oh my god. Oh, those glasses. I mean, I was gonna say, I have this feeling, but Zeke knows that he's, like, a royal and stuff. Because, like, at the beginning of the season, I was under the impression that he never knew. But now, as I keep seeing, he knows he has royal blood. Oh, grandparents? Yeah, there's no way his parents, like, are so into, yeah, liberating them, and he never knew what they were doing. He knew. Oh. Man, imagine this as your story time. I don't think he wants to do it. He just did it to make his parents happy. Baseball. Man, kid just wants to have fun. Oh my God. He already read this story last night. And he practically memorized the book. Man, feels so bad for this kid. Oh, he's gonna get scolded. It's too late at night. Oh, they wanted Zeke to be chosen. Man, I know you're desperate, but dang, you're his dad. I feel so bad for him. Man, and this Magus guy's like, you're worthless. Why do we need you? And all the other kids look like way bigger. Oh man, they came to watch. Oh, the shame. Oh my God. Man, he literally had just has that guy. Oh my goodness. I thought his dad would treat him differently, but. Oh. You think he purposely told on his parents? So then. Man, I need a backstory on the first Ymir. Man, I wonder how he passed. Oh, so they know the traitor and so is that why he told on? Dang, it's that Grisha, you look so. That's your kid there. Oh, he's gonna get slapped or something. Oh man, I'm feeling so bad for him. Oh! He told him. I mean, I side with him. He had enough, right? He's ready to just let it go, just, you know, just take me out. So he ratted his parents out, but. Oh. Oh no, is that his plan?
is that his plan with, does Eren know?
I imagine he told Eren this plan, and I think Eren agrees. Listening to it? Well, when he says father, he meant cassava. And this is when they told him. Oh, but when he said, told Eren in season 3 about his dad, oh, he's been brainwashed, man. Oh my god, everything is connecting! Oh my god. And they both came to the same conclusion. Yeah, don't touch yet. Oh wow. I felt bad about what I said about him last episode. But at the time, I felt hurt because he turned all the Levi's men. But what if he told Levi the Pan? Oh, shoot, he moved! Is he? It better not. Fudge. Oh man, that was three episodes. That was so fast. I know I say every time, and there's nothing at the end. And I believe next episode is season finale, episode 16. Man, oh my gosh. I mean, like, now that like you see the whole backstory, it makes sense. It just parts of me doesn't like the fact that I understand like his plan to like make everyone not able to give birth, or like this is where the euthanization, but so many people had to die for this. I don't know. Man, I just totally felt so bad about him, his growing up, and man, his father was Mr. Cassava. Yeah, his dad is horrible, Grisha. Damn. I don't remember if Grisha was that bad to Eden, but then again, I can't really say because because Grisha's always been like busy, and Eden only got to see him like, occasionally, but man, so much suffering for all the kids in ALT. Like, they all grew up with such a horrible past. We saw Reiner's at the earlier this year. This episode top it off, Zeke. God damn it, man. Like, the previous episode I was kind of like angry at him because I was like, oh man, he's the reason that everyone is just like all messed up right now. He manipulated Eden and all that. And then this episode I get to see like the real reason. Zeke found someone he could bond with. Like, all he wanted was to spend a little family time with his dad. And man, the dude, like, left and right, morning to night, just giving him, like, that death stare. And that's horrible to do to the kid like that. And the only person was, like, the previous Beast Titan who, shared his stories, played catch with him. That's all he ever wanted. It broke my heart seeing this story. And then when the Mr. Cassava was like, my wife and son died because LD and Marla, the thing. Yeah, and then I was looking for a son through you, and then he was looking for a father through him, and I'm like, oh my gosh, such a touching moment. And we get the reveal of how he like told on his parents. Like, he told them to stop, but they wouldn't listen. Like, sometimes Grisha's mind is just so narrow and stubborn. I mean, he didn't know what was coming, and frankly, Zeke just told him to stop, like, just please, like, for the peace of everything. But his parents didn't. It was mostly Grisha talking and giving the look. And like, the mom didn't do anything either. Yeah, just sit back and let the dad do everything. Oh my gosh. I felt so bad for Zeke every single moment. So like when he finally told him them, I was like, oh, thank God, I don't even care. Or I was like, oh, Zeke, you're wrong. You've been brainwashed. And you find out a little more truth, a little more. And in this episode, you get the real backstory of Zeke. And oh, I feel so bad. Damn. And Mr. Cassava was like happy when he died because he got to live through Zeke, essentially. And but mostly since he said he worked, he does Titan research. He told Zeke that with the Founding Titan's powers, you're able to reconstruct your body. So essentially, Zeke's plan is to, you know, team up with Eden, and then they can, like, euthanize. I guess they were just gonna sterilize all the guys, all the male and female's sperm and eggs or whatnot. I don't know how they're gonna do it, but, like, reconstruct the body so no one can be pregnant again. Good times. No more suffering. We don't have to kill anyone, but no one has to have kids. In a way, that's kind of sad because, you know, thinking about it, like, I'm sure people always thought, wow, Mikasa and Eren are going to have kids, shipping John and Mikasa, shipping Armin and Annie, like, you know, whatever floats your boat. And now, if that actually happens, they can never have kids. Damn. How else are you going to stop the Titan War? I mean, I feel like if they told other people, I mean, I know they kept everything hidden for a reason, but I feel like maybe if they explained to Levi, Hanji, Pixie, that maybe they would listen. Do you think that would happen? Yeah, I mean, I know Hanji, you know, she didn't want to listen for a while, so that's why Eren had to escape and do this, but I feel like they didn't try to explain too much. I could be wrong. And then at the very end, even though Levi said, like, it's close enough to his stomach that it could just rip him in half and kill him, I get the feeling, like, there was a part in the previous episode that after Levi took his body, there was, like, a piece of flesh that still moved. I don't know how that would, like, connect, but somehow it still moving makes me feel like there's a piece of Zeke in it. But then again, Zeke might be able to survive this. Maybe his intentions were just to, like, damage Levi enough. Maybe he sensed Eren was nearby, I don't know. But the thing is, like, a lot of the people in the MP is about to turn into the Pure Titans. That whole room where they felt the electricity, I'm scared for what's to come. Still, Flock is the character I hate the most in this series. Yeah, I know a lot of people hate Gabby. I still think maybe it's just me that I have, like, you know, children are children. They don't know. And in the end, she was just a victim. They're all victims of this, like, endless cycle. And this is where it has to end. It's, wow, goodness. Anyways, that is pretty much it for this reaction. Feel free to leave me your comments and thoughts. I'll be sure to read them and see you guys for next reaction. Peace.